You've tried everything. Anti-inflammatories, antivirals, mitochondrial supplements, pacing protocols, but you're still stuck with crushing fatigue that never gets better. What if the problem isn't your mitochondria? What if it's not your immune system? What if tiny, invisible clots are quietly choking off oxygen to your cells and nobody's been looking for them? Today, we're diving into microclots and the enzymes that might break them apart. But first, I need to tell you why this has been missed for so long. I'm Courtney, and on this channel, we explore evidence-based treatments for complex chronic illness. No hype, no false promises, just what the science actually says. In the last few years, researchers started looking in a completely different direction in post-viral conditions like ME/CFS and long COVID, not at viruses or immunity, but at blood flow. And what they found might change everything. Microclots are not regular blood clots. They're dense, fibrin-rich structures that trap inflammatory proteins and resist normal breakdown, making them virtually impossible to detect on typical blood testing. Regular blood tests can't find them. You need special microscopes that most doctors and labs just don't have. So that's what's so frustrating. We might have been missing a treatable aspect of post-viral illness for years simply because we couldn't see it. In long COVID and ME/CFS, studies show that these microclots clog the tiniest blood vessels, your capillaries, essentially cutting off oxygen delivery to our tissues. And that's a big deal. Low oxygen at the cellular level means energy failure, immune dysfunction, and oxidative stress. So this could help explain some of the hallmark symptoms like post-exertional malaise, brain fog that won't lift, and crushing fatigue that doesn't improve with rest. One study found microclots in nearly every long COVID patient tested, and another study in 2023 found similar results in ME/CFS patients. So why aren't we talking more about this? Keep watching, because next we'll look at two enzymes that might help break microclots down. You might be asking yourself, can't we just take a blood thinner? Well, not quite. Medications like warfarin or Coumadin are designed to prevent new clots, not necessarily dissolve the ones that are already there. And microclots are particularly stubborn to break down. So researchers started looking at fibrinolytic enzymes, compounds that can actually dissolve these stubborn little clots. And here's where it gets very interesting. One enzyme comes from fermented soybeans and the other from earthworms. Yeah, worms. Let's start with nattokinase. This was discovered in 1987. It's an enzyme that's produced during the fermentation of natto, a traditional Japanese food. But don't run to the grocery store just yet. The nattokinase in supplements is very different from eating actual natto. In lab and human studies, nattokinase has been shown to break down fibrin directly, stimulate the body's own clot-dissolving enzymes, and lower levels of clot-promoting proteins. But here's what people fail to mention. Nattokinase is a protein. So if you take it at the wrong time or in the wrong form, it's destroyed in your stomach before it can do anything in your circulation. I'll explain how to avoid this costly mistake in just a moment. Let's look now at lumbrokinase. This enzyme comes from the earthworm Lumbricus rubellus. Yes, really. But don't be fooled. This isn't folk medicine anymore. Lumbrokinase has been used in clinical trials for decades, including for stroke and poor circulation. It works in two ways. It breaks down fibrin directly, and it helps the body make plasmin, your internal clot-busting enzyme. What makes it especially promising is it's more selective. It doesn't mess with your normal clotting ability, and that's very important for older patients or fragile patients. Some doctors even report that it's more potent than nattokinase, but there's limited head-to-head research here yet. So how can we take these enzymes to get maximum effect? This is where most people mess up and waste their money. Here's the hard truth. If you get any of these three things wrong, you're throwing your money away supplementing with enzymes. First, they must be taken on an empty stomach. Digestive enzymes that are activated at a meal will destroy these enzymes before they can work. So you must wait 45 to 60 minutes before eating, or at least 2 hours after a meal to take them. Second thing, only buy enteric-coated capsules. Without that special coating, your stomach acid kills these enzymes instantly. And third, you want to stick to research-proven forms. that are patented. Generic forms are just often worthless. The two most studied are NSK-SD for Nattokinase and Boluoke for Lumbrokinase. Both of these have consistent potency and are used in numerous clinical trials. So please, don't waste your money on generic versions that don't include these patented formulas. Enzyme therapy only works when these compounds can actually reach your bloodstream intact. Here's what the research and clinical experience suggest about dosing. For Nattokinase, you start with 2,000 units daily split into two doses. For Lumbrokinase, most people just start with one capsule per day. Higher doses do exist for these, but they should only be used under medical supervision. Here's the key as well. More isn't always better. Start low, monitor effects, and work with someone experienced in enzyme therapy. And before you go and buy these online, there's something critical you need to know about safety. Most people do tolerate these enzymes well, but they are pharmacologically active, and not everyone should take them. You want to avoid fibrinolytic enzymes if you're already on a blood thinner, if you've had a recent surgery or will in the future, if you have active bleeding or are pregnant, or if you're significantly underweight. Mild side effects include nausea, dizziness, or minor bruising, and they're more likely with higher doses. The bottom line here is don't self-prescribe. Work with someone who understands post-viral illness and enzyme therapy. We're still early in the research, but the role of microclots in post-viral illness is gaining attention fast. If those clots are a root cause or even a major contributor, then breaking them down might be the missing link in post-viral treatment. Nattokinase and Lumbrokinase, they aren't miracle cures, but they are promising tools worth watching closely as we learn more. This video is a summary of a blog post, which is linked below. There you will find all the research citations I mentioned. So, I want to hear from you. Have you noticed improvement with enzyme therapy? Share your experience below. I read every comment. And if you found this helpful, hit that like button. It tells YouTube to show this to other people who might be struggling with the same issues. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more evidence-based strategies for ME/CFS, long COVID, and fibromyalgia. I'll see you in the next video.